Sorry, I know these corridors are a labyrinth, but well, that's the point, to keep intruders out. I suppose I should warn you, there are also a few infected roaming around in here. Used to be Omega Group soldiers, you see, but, well, they're all infected now. Terrible shame. Do make yourself at home, but please don't touch anything. This is all vital scientific work. I'll close the door behind you, just a precaution. Sorry, I can't greet you in person. It's safer for both of us, you understand. I'm researching a cure for this terrible infection, you see. It's slow going, as I have so few subjects to test on. Like those poor Omega Group soldiers. Not my finest hour, I fear. If you'll forgive me for a moment, I'm sure you can help me. I say, steady on, old girl. Right. Now here's how you could help. There's a book, De Remedi Secreti, by Conrad Gesner. A fascinating text, but what I'm after is Dee's own copy where he made annotations. I believe it's in the palace library, which means going upstairs, I'm afraid. Would you be so kind? The bunker elevator can take you up to the palace. I hope you don't mind the music, by the way. William Byrd, Elizabeth I's favorite composer, apparently. I find it helps me work, it's very soothing. You're doing ever so well. I do feel awful about the poor guards. Well, technically, I'm an Omega Group myself. Started as an army medic, and then they posted me here. It's such a shame. Those soldiers were an elite. So sad to see them like this.
The angel chided me thus. Ignorance was the nakedness whereby you first were tormented, and the first plague that fell upon man was the wanting of science. The angel chided me thus. Ignorance was the nakedness whereby you first were tormented, and the first plague that fell upon man was the wanting of science. The want of science hinders you from knowledge of your own self.
Thank you.
I've just realized you probably have no idea what Omega Group is. Top secret, you see, but that hardly matters now. It's an elite group to protect the royal family. But the outbreak caught us on the hop, and now all these poor men who used to guard the bunker... Well, I suppose you could say they're still guarding it. If only we'd paid more attention to Dr. D. down.
Patients succumb immediately to infection in the region where the malady enters the body. Violent convulsions follow, and their veins turn black as ink. Poisoned blood radiates from the wound, spreading like the roots of a venomous tree, accelerated by unnatural haste. It would be beautiful if not for its dark design.
This is where it all started, and this is where it'll end. I promise you. Protect the safe house. Your survival depends on it.
back again. No luck finding the Gesner book upstairs, I see. Well, sorry, but I must return to my work. Do help yourself to anything you need, won't you? Ah, back again. No luck finding the Gesner book upstairs, I see. Well, sorry, but I must return to my work. Do help yourself to anything you need, won't you?
The patients succumb immediately to infection in the region where the malady enters the body. Violent convulsions follow, and their veins turn black as ink. Poisoned blood radiates from the wound, spreading like the roots of a venomous tree, accelerated by unnatural haste. It would be beautiful, if not for its dark design. The patients succumb immediately to infection in the region where the malady enters the body.
Better than that.
In some subjects, pockets filled with a rich, acrid pus form near hot, inflamed areas around the groin, armpits, and jaw. I have extracted this liquid for further investigation. The patient must be restrained and cannot be calmed by any manner of herbal sedative. She seems ravenous, and nothing I feed her can satiate her monstrous appetite. As if compelled by a most foul instinct to devour all life within her reach. She freed herself of her bonds yesterday and would have gutted our horse alive if I had not reached her in time. I find myself in awe of the piteous state to which man is reduced. A walking conduit, a mere empty coil, which lives only to feed its greedy and carnal instincts.
Where was I? You must forgive me, I'm a little distracted. Ah yes, Dr. Dee. John Dee was a scientist, alchemist, natural philosopher and all that, to Elizabeth I. Some people say he was even a spy. Imagine that. And Dee wrote a warning, you see, about this outbreak. Oh, dear. Sorry, must dash.
Following the recommendations of De Remedi Secreti, I reduced the pus to a dry powder and discovered that injecting the concoction into the subject... God forgive me that I refer to my own wife as subject... causes the black blood to retract and wither. I glimpsed the flush of my wife's once rosy complexion through the sickness. But alas, she then succumbed to one final fit. And at last, with blessed mercy, ceased moving forever. May God have mercy upon her soul, and allow it now to rest. I remain convinced this volume offers practical methods for obtaining a solution. Perhaps even the key to save us all.
Hello. Oh, I see you found Gesner's book. I do hope it wasn't too much trouble. I'd pass it through, would you? Wait. There's something else. That gadget of yours looks rather like something the Omega chaps used to carry. Would you step over there and scan that infected chap with it? A full scan and analyze, mind you, to isolate the infected gland. The human body really is a fascinating thing. Even after all vital signs in the subject cease, the body continues to fight the infection. Amazing, eh? I thought so. You'll have to put him out of his misery first. Then take the syringe and fill it up with antibodies from the infected gland. Perfect. Now, that syringe will synthesize a viricide, a sort of poison, quite deadly. There's enough for one injection, but you can refill it from another willing volunteer. In return, I need another favor. A second book, Studium Contagione, The Study of Infection by D himself. It's very rare, but I happen to know Ron Friedman has a copy in his flat on Brick Lane. Ron's one of those Raven chaps, you see.
I know you're green as grass, but try and remember to aim before you shoot.